Hi, I'm Jim Freilinger, Chemigation Consultant with the Minnesota Department of Agriculture. What we're going to do today is go through introduction or a quick inspection of your chemigation anti-pollution device prior to season startup. And you should do it periodically throughout the year just to make sure everything is working. First of all, you want to make sure as you unhook your vacuum brake, pull that off, make sure that the ball inside is free, that it works. While you've got that off, you can take a look down inside, down to your low pressure drain, which is right directly at the bottom. Make sure that that is clear, that there's no sand, rust, or other particles that can plug that pipe. And when you're also reaching in there, give your flapper valve a little bit of a push. Make sure that it springs back shut, that the spring is working. Once you've completed that part on the inside, put your vacuum brake back on. Make sure you put the clamp on and that you clamp it tight. Once you're done with that, as you can see, check your low pressure drain. As you can see, we had a little bit of water in our pipe and our low pressure drain is working. It's draining the water out that was left inside. Low pressure valve has to be installed on the bottom side of your anti-pollution device. It has to be, the whole system has to be in a horizontal position. The reason for this valve is if there's any water that comes back, seeps past your flipper valve, and rather than letting the water go down into your well, it falls down into this elbow and then out through this low pressure drain. And what it is doing, like this one is showing, the spring has opened it up. Any water that comes down into here now comes out your low pressure drain, falls on the ground versus going back down into your well, causing adverse effects onto the groundwater, whether we don't want nitrogen or any pesticides getting into the groundwater. So this keeps the water from getting into the well when the system is shut down. After you've checked and made sure everything is up and in operation like it's supposed to be, you can then hook up your injection pump to your injection port, which has your back check inside, or your injection point and your back check inside your anti-pollution device.